Rockstar Superstar Project is here for the Rock and Recovery Tour 2011, where we are spreading hope, encouraging and inspiring others to dream, catch, make responsible choices.
See your hands in the air. Come on. I see your targets, I know your pain. Wastelands of broken dreams and my scattered remains. I do what you tell me, I do what you need. My soul is blackened, for you I bleed. Without you by my side, without you could I go on and survive? It's not the way you use and abuse me. It's the way you make me feel worthless. It's not the way you use and abuse me. In everything that I know, you hold me close just like I hold you. I can't escape you, you're always near. I do what you tell me, I do what you need. But without you, I can't seem to be free. No. Don't know what I would do without you by my time. Without you could I go on and survive? It's not the way you use and abuse me. It's the way you make me feel worthless. It's not the way you use and abuse me. In everything that I know. We all have to
Of addiction, my addiction, were so deep in me that at times I couldn't even see the most beautiful thing that I had in my own reflection, and that was my self-worth. So we're going to slow things down for just a moment, because I want to read to you something that I wrote, a letter that I wrote to my addiction. Dear addiction, I know you hate me. I know you want me to fail at everything that I try to do in life. Fail at everything, create havoc everywhere I go. To stop loving and to start hating everyone and everything in my life. But I cannot let this relationship continue, and I won't. You're selfish, and it's been completely all about you from day one, hasn't it? You must understand, and I know you understand, my perspective. I love life, enjoy its happiness, enjoy knowing who I am today. Why would you want to ever take this from me? Truth be known, I've been disappointed in you for quite some time. What started out as fun ended up becoming a nightmare. And I believed you when you told me that you would take care of me. You never took care of me, because you're a murderer, a whirlwind of doom that just wants me dead. I didn't see that then, but I could see that now. How could I have been so naive? I know you will be watching every move that I make for the rest of my life, dear addiction, but I won't be paying you any more attention. So this is our final goodbye. I'm sorry, but it has to be this way. P.S., dear addiction, you were never good anyway. You know what, when I came to New York, there was a bar owner that called my cell phone and said, "Hey, we got a little something down here for you and your brother." So I drove to that bar in New York, and I walk in, and the bar owner takes me to the very back, where they served the liquor, and he pointed at a chair, a bar stool. So he turned the bar stool around, and on the back, where the back rests, was a gold plate that read, Doug. Doug's chair, that's what that gold plate read. So then that bar owner pointed at a picture behind the bar of Doug, and at that point, it all became clear. Most people knew Doug as an alcoholic, but my brother and I knew Doug as our father. So, for anyone that's lost anyone to the disease of addiction, to anyone who knows anyone whose life was lost way too soon from addiction, come to the front of the stage. This next song, Alone You Breathe, goes out to them.
Till inside a race with night, you just let go.